As long as man has ruled the world, big brothers and little brothers, big sisters and little sisters have been competing and fighting. And that's kind of the basis of the comparison of this video, because this is the big brother and the little brother, of course, with the same parent, Epson Group. So on the left side, we have the ORIENT Triton. This is the RA-EL0002L. And on the other side here, we have the Seiko Turtle, the legend, the Seiko Turtle, and this is the blue version, the SRP-773J1. So both of these watches are Japanese, blue, 200 meter, ISO certified dive watches with in-house movements, great lume, and all the stuff you know from these watches. The reason why I wanted to compare these watches is because they're kind of close within the same price range. Now, this was released some years ago and it was priced at around $800 to $900. If you want a more thorough and in-depth review of this ORIENT Triton professional dive watch with the power reserve indicator here up at between 12 and 2, you can find the link down in the description or up in the right hand corner. You can watch that video afterwards. And this is of course the Turtle. This is also an older version of the Turtle, and this is of course a very legendary design stemming back to the 60s, a legendary dive watch design, the Turtle, with this beautiful cushion shaped case. This is also getting quite affordable. I paid $339 for this one. Usually you would pay maybe around $400, $450, and that actually places both watches within the same price range, somewhere between $400 and $500. So if we start with the Seiko Turtle, this is the blue version. I did put it on an aftermarket Jubilee bracelet. It comes on a oyster style bracelet, which is really, really bad. So I took that one off. So it's an automatic dive watch. It's powered by the in-house 4R36 movement, which has a power reserve of 40 hours. So it's powered by the in-house 4R36 movement, which is an automatic movement with manual winding and hacking functions. It has a power reserve of 40 hours, 24 joules, and beats at a rate of 21,600 vibrations per hour. Out of the factory, really, really, really bad tolerances. It's not even acceptable. So out of the factory, Seiko state that you can't expect any more accuracy than minus 35 or plus 45. That's really bad. It's a 2011 movement, but still, that's not good enough. But actually, when I measured it on my time grapher, it's all over the place, but the most consistent rate is minus 1 to plus 3 seconds. So actually, most of the time, this watch is within COSC specifications, which I find really nice. The size is a big one. It's 44.9 millimeters from side to side. That's because it's this cushion shape. As you can see, it has this cushion shape case. The thickness is 13 millimeters, which is really nice for a nice big chunky professional dive watch as this one, from lock tip to lock tip. And that's a really, really important measurement. Only 47.6 millimeters, which means you can easily wear this watch, even though it's almost 45 millimeters. It actually wears a little bit smaller because it's not very long from lock tip to lock tip. You also notice that you actually get drilled lock holes, a crown at 4 o'clock, high polish on the sides of the case, brushing on the top on both sides here. You can see really old school with the drilled lock holes, so you can easily change straps. And then you get a screw down case back. I did keep the sticker on, but it's the Seiko Wave on the backside here. So getting into the ORIENT Triton, this is kind of the professional dive watch within the ORIENT line. It was at least a few years ago. They also have a saturation dive watch, which is really popular and more expensive than this one. So in this watch, we also have a in-house movement. It has a 200 meter water resistance, just like the Seiko. This is the 405 NA movement. Tolerances are a little bit better, but still not really good out of the factory. Minus 15 to plus 25. This is also a 2011 movement. It has 22 joules. And as you can see, we get a 40 hour power reserve complication. And that's of course because it has 40 hours of power reserve. So you can also always check the power reserve indicator up here. It's a really useful complication to see how much power reserve you have left in this watch. When I measure this watch, we actually get minus 1 to minus 2 seconds. That's absolutely amazing. Much better than the Seiko and much better than ORIENT actually say out of the factory. I'm so extremely lucky all the time with Seiko watches and ORIENT watches regarding the accuracy. And also to just stay in the blue, and when we're talking of accuracy, a completely other different watch. This is the Precise SARX053. This is with the artisan blue enamel dial. So we're staying within the blue Epson group watches, but a different style. This watch is 43.6 millimeters from side to side. It has a 51 millimeter lock to lock distance, so quite a few millimeters more than the Seiko, although the Seiko is bigger in its diameter. 22 millimeter lock width and 13.9 millimeters in thickness, so this definitely will wear thicker than the Seiko. Again, we get polished sides, drilled lock holes, which is really nice, old school, a signed crown, screw down crown. The Seiko also has a screw down crown, but this is signed, which is a really nice feature, brushing on the top of the locks. And again, we have a solid case back with a really nice engraving of the ORIENT logo. This is, of course, as I said before, also a 200 meter water resistant dive watch. This is also fitted with an aftermarket bracelet. This is a strap coat oyster style bracelet, which is really, really nice. You can see the beautiful taper, the clasp, and the bracelet is just so much better than ORIENT's factory bracelet, because that's just so bad, just like the Seiko. Really, really nothing to write home about. Both watches, of course, have crystals. This is a sapphire crystal with AR treatment. This is only a hardlex, which is a letdown. Hardlex is a mineral crystal and not as scratch resistant as sapphire crystal. So the quality is definitely better on this side. This is, of course, also maybe approximately $100 more expensive than the Seiko. You can see both watches have typical dive style layouts on the dial. The difference is that you actually get the logo and the printing of the water resistance above 6 o'clock on the ORIENT. On the Seiko, you get the Seiko name at 12 o'clock and then prospects and 200 meters of water resistance above 6 o'clock. Both watches have applied hour markings, which is really nice. It does seem that they're kind of almost printed on the dial with the Seiko, whereas it more looks a little more refined and also applied on the ORIENT, as you can see. Definitely differences here. Both has aluminium bezel inserts, 120 clicks. The Seiko is a little bit stiffer than the ORIENT, but I'm so fortunate because I actually got a Seiko where everything aligns. That's quite amazing. It's nothing you really are winning the lottery these days if you get a Seiko where everything aligns. As you can hear, much stronger sound. Really nice bezel action. Everything aligns, but I do, although it's a little bit stiffer on the Seiko, prefer the Seiko bezel action. They really got it right, and also on my SKX, it's a really nice thing to turn the bezel. The interesting thing about these two watches is that you actually get great loom on both watches. Lumibright, which is the proprietary Seiko loom, which also ORIENT uses because they are within the same parent company. Great loom on both. I definitely think that the Seiko wins. Seiko are just loom kings, but definitely really nice loom on the ORIENT as well. So an interesting thing is also both of these watches come with each of their complications. This, of course, has the power reserve. I really like that you get a power reserve. Usually watches with power reserves, they are a little more expensive than other complications. So it's a really nice feature. And around 4 o'clock here, you get the date complication. With the Seiko, you actually get another complication because you get the day-date complication. So you can both read the day and the date. Very useful. It might be the 28th today, but is it Thursday or Wednesday? I can't remember. And that's a really useful complication. I think that overall, it just fits a dive watch better with a small date window compared to the day-date complication. Who needs to know which day it actually is when you're down diving? So on my 17.5 to 18 centimeter wrist and circumference, you can see this almost 44 millimeter big watch with a lock-to-lock distance of 51 millimeters wears really nicely. I can easily pull it off. It does wear closer to maybe a 42.5 or 42 millimeter watch than a almost 44 millimeter watch. It wears a little bit top heavy because it is a heavy watch with the complication inside, but I really like the overall feel and weight on the wrist and with a aftermarket bracelet compared to the crappy bracelet you get from the factory, it really makes a nice package. And here we have the Seiko Turtle. As you can see, it definitely wears bigger because it's this big cushion shaped case, which is almost 45 millimeters. But as you can see, because it's cushion shaped, you only get 47.6 millimeters from lock tip to lock tip, and that actually makes the watch wear a little bit smaller. I like the overall look on the Jubilee bracelet because it really just makes it look like kind of a vintage dive watch. So this is the conclusion of the comparison of these two watches. Remember, you can see full reviews of these watches if you click on the links down in the description if you want more details and measurements of both watches. I really think that they are really close, and I think actually they make kind of a cool, affordable Japanese dive watch collection. Maybe you can swap the colors so you get one of these in black maybe and the other in blue, but I really like blue watches, so I'm really happy about having both of these watches in blue. I do think we get a little bit better quality and a better complication and dial layout with the Orient, but you get better bezel action and you definitely get much more history and heritage with the Seiko. With the Orient, you get sapphire crystal. You only get hard legs with the Seiko. It's not a big, big problem, but I just think it's definitely also something to consider. So which of these two Japanese dive watches is your favorite? Leave a comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. It is what keeps this channel running, that I get more subscribers. It's really motivating to make more videos when you see that people enjoy them. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.